Moving. few drinks, thought I'd usher in the apocalypse considering that it's a new year. How you doing? Not actually ushering in the... It's Darksiders. We're, you know, the end of the world here. Happy New Year. So, in case you're not familiar with this game, it's Darksiders. Kind of a combination of Darksiders, Devil May Cry, and The Legend of Zelda. You play as War of the Fortress of Power. And as you can see, all hell has been unleashed on Earth. I don't know anybody who's just walking in. We've never played this game before. The first game, yeah, this is the War Master's Den. You hate New Year's and those 4th of July, heard it on the news every day, what? You hate the New Year's and the 4th of July, Ethan? Why? Why do you hate both of those things in particular? Yeah, this is the War Master Edition. I'm playing the PC version, so I can't really tap out the graphics or type anything in chat right now, or else I'll end up pausing the game. But yeah, this is the PC version. But this is also available on Xbox One and PS4. See if I can fix that. I'll fix that real quick. Right there ought to do it. All right, how's that? I know one gripe a lot of people have about the remastered version of Darksiders across all versions is they did something weird with the sound. Like, they have asymmetrical sound during the cutscenes. And the voiceovers are very loud compared to all of the background sound effects and the music. Other than that, it's not so bad. I think it looks pretty nice, and since I already had the original version on PC, I got this for free, so can't really complain about any quirks that there, you know, that exist. Yeah, it has been a long time. I can never pronounce your name correctly, Asacrio. I know it's a portmanteau of a Pokemon name, but I can never get it right. It would probably help if I was, if I was a more avid Pokemon fan. I have Angel shooting at me too. Hey, LC. Happy New Year. Yeah, I just decided it's been a while since I streamed. And, you know, it's something besides Metroid. I figure, yeah, on New Year's, I'll do a casual stream. But I also have some drinks with me to usher in the new year and to usher in the apocalypse early, because we're playing Darksiders. Asacryo. Asacryo or Asacryo? Asacryo. You can hear gunpowder out there, it's dangerous, you don't like it. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of exploding noises. Which, well, too bad for me, because it's kind of a rainy, thundery, stormy night for a New Year's. It's raining outside. We saw some lightning, heard some thunder. It's kind of died down a bit. But if I all of a sudden just kind of, like, cut out on you, it's probably because our power went out. Cryo. Asacryo. I can assure you I will forget. Hello, Angel. Goodbye, Angel. He just got taken by a giant bat thing. Get the hell out of here. Nope. Those guys are just gonna climb up and try to get me again. If you hear some voices in the background, my boys are in the room here with me. They get to stay up a little late tonight. Yeah, it's like God of War, Devil May Cry, and The Legend of Zelda combined. Waste of money. Alright. Got my son a Google Play card, and he decided to get the Minecraft Pocket Edition. I don't know why, because they have the Minecraft Xbox One Edition, which you'd think is better. Then again, I don't really play Minecraft, so what do I know? Yeah, I guess you could say it's kind of like Dante's Inferno, because you kind of have the whole heaven and hell thing going. But I always thought Dante's Inferno was more like a cheap, just a straight-up God of War ripoff, you know, uninspired by the likes of, like, The Legend of Zelda. Where are you? Where'd you go? Did I kill him? I guess I killed him. Okay, he's gone. Although, I'll be honest with you, I played maybe the first few hours of Dante's Inferno, and I didn't really like it. Oh no, it just didn't do it for me. Which is weird, because I do like the God of War games. I have pretty much the whole God of War series, with the exception of God of War Ascension. Is that it? Ascension? I heard that one kind of sucked, though, but I don't know. I haven't tried it for myself. I really should. But I heard it sucked, which was weird to me because I've never heard of anybody outright saying that a God of War game sucked. I mean, I heard them say that they weren't as good as some others, like the PSP games. No, they're not as good. Even though I never played them on PSP, I played Chains of Olympus and Ghost of Sparta on PS3 because I have the Origins Collection.
Impossible. Abaddon. What is this?
Abaddon.
Where are my brothers? This cannot be. The final seal.
Oh, hello, Troy Baker. You're in absolutely everything. Yeah, Troy Baker voices Abaddon. Do I know Ash Ketchum from Ash Ketchum from... Do you know Ash Ketchum from Ash Ketchum from Pokemon? They create games and movies and more than that. I like Pokemon fans. What? I know who Ash Ketchum is.
The seventh seal.
Even though I'm not that much of a Pokemon fan, but I mean, I have kids, and I like Nintendo, so most of my Pokemon knowledge comes from Super Smash Brothers and my kids. Do I recommend buying a Wii U or waiting for the Switch? Maybe it will have backwards compatibility. If the Switch does have backwards compatibility, it will be... See, it uses cartridges, kind of like game cards, like with the Nintendo 3DS, so I don't think it'll be straight up backwards compatible. So if you want to play Wii U games, you're going to have to get a Wii U unless they port Wii U games to the Switch. That's the only other way I can think of you playing those games, because you won't be able to take a Wii U game and just put it into the Switch because there's no optical drive. So I'd say it's up to you. I would recommend, because the Switch is a good console. The only reason it underperformed is because Nintendo didn't market it very well. But it is good, and I would recommend getting it because it has some good games. I mean, but I don't know what Nintendo has planned. They might port more of its successful games to the Switch. Alright, so we got kind of our first tutorial boss fight here. But he has several opportunities to screw you up. I haven't really been talking about this boss fight. But he repeats the same cycle. Alright, so hold up. He's going to slam down on the ground. You take damage. You take like shockwave damage when he slams on the ground like that. So you want to jump in the air. Also right here, jump in the air. He slams the streak down so you don't take damage. Digital backwards compatibility, you mean like how you can download Wii games? So you're thinking more of a virtual console thing. Maybe. The thing is that there won't be dual screen functionality for the Switch. So, I don't know how they'll do it. Because if they were to like, for example, if they made Xenoblade Chronicles X a digital download, that game is very reliant on your ability to use two screens. So, I don't know how they would do that. I'm not saying it's impossible or can't happen or won't happen. I just don't see how they would. But then again, I don't design video games for a living, so that maybe they'll find a way.
Has been broken.
By the way, this game right here, if you have a Wii U, it will be available on the Wii U. They haven't really said when, but there is a Wii U version of the Darksiders Warmastered Edition coming out for Wii U. Only thing is it'll only run at 30 frames per second, whereas every other version, like on the PS4, Xbox One, and PC, which is the one I'm playing, it runs at 60 frames.
Four horsemen shall ride forth to punish the wicked.
I mean, yeah, the dual screens, some might work. To be perfectly honest with you, I was about to say Super Mario 3D World might work, but then again, you have to use the, well, No, because you can use the right stick to control the camera. I was going to say you needed to use the gamepad to play the Captain Toad sections. But that's really only because they forced you to do it. I really saw no reason why you couldn't play those sections and use the right stick. By the way, yeah, I'm playing with an Xbox One controller. All of them intact. So, yeah. War is one of the four horsemen of the apocalypse. For some reason, he was the only one summoned, and now they're saying that they're holding him responsible for ushering in the apocalypse early, because mankind was not ready. Those seven seals were not meant to be broken, and the end war, the apocalypse, was not meant to happen until mankind grew strong enough as a species to fight angels and demons. Hey, Org, how you doing?
Powerless against
any
the demons.
Any console ports have to be limited to 30 FPS to keep details up, like Deus Ex Mankind Divided barely ran at 30, and they recommend an NVIDIA 970 for PC. And even that's kind of shooting. That's for, like, that's recommended settings.
Not
really minimum.
Only the council. Only the
they could release the gamepad with screen for the Switch for Wii U games. Maybe.
I will punish the maybe. Ones
right now, I really don't see how they're doing unless they allow they could allow the Wii U gamepad to be synced with it.
Then I will fail.
That could be a thing.
And the demons will have carried out your sentence.
Very well. You will return to Earth.
You know what, though? Not all console ports are limited to 30 FPS. The console ports of this game right here run at... Well, at least the PS4 and the Xbox One versions run at 60 FPS. I mean, honestly, I would rather them dumb down the details just a little bit to get... Because, honestly, I mean, I rarely play... Even PC games, I rarely max out their settings because I care more about a smooth frame rate over anything else. Because what's the point of the game looking good if it doesn't feel playable? And I have a Radeon R9 290X, and I don't even run Deus Ex Human Revolution at full specs, let alone Mankind Divided. Some of the native 4K PS4 Pro releases have had issues with FPS at 4K. Yeah, that's even with PC, though. But then again, I never play at 4K, ever, because I don't have a 4K monitor. I don't have 4K TV, so there's no point. But that's just me. But from what I hear, even people with high-end PCs have hits to the frame rate when they're playing at 4K. Oh yeah, I can max out Human Revolution as well. I just don't. I'll be honest, I play a lot of PC games, but I don't really care about high graphical fidelity. I'll get a PC game, and I'll leave its settings alone. I think the most I'll do is I'll crank up the anisotropic filter. That's about it. And, you know, just so, you know, yeah, I'll crank up the anti-aliasing just so I don't get as much jaggies. But then again, like, I have a 22-inch monitor right here. And right in front of me, I have a 32-inch. Now, on a 32-inch screen, you can barely tell the difference between 720 and 1080.
Seek the demon.
Do I only play on PC and Nintendo? No, I also play PlayStation. We have an Xbox One, but that's in my kids' room. I don't touch it.
Since the truce was broken, some demons have fallen from the destroyer's favor.
Yeah, well, the R9 290X can do 4K, I just don't because I don't have a 4K monitor.
How long have I been here?
Well, not anymore, because it broke, Justin. It It broke last January, a month after the warranty expired. And I considered getting a new one, but maybe. Maybe I'll wait until the PS4 goes down, or PS4 Pro goes down. Because I heard that even has higher performance at 1080, like a better, more consistent frame rate.
Looks like
it just died. Like, it just stopped turning on.
Not so fast, horseman.
By the way, listen to this character, the Watcher. He's voiced by Mark Hamill. You know, the Joker.
Rules. Until this is over, you're a dog on a leash. I say bark, you bark, and if I have to kick you...
Mark Hamill's good in everything. Does anything Mark Hamill's in, it's good. It's good. That's why I like The Force Awakens. To me, Force Awakens is a perfectly fine movie, no flaws whatsoever, because Mark Hamill was in it for 10 seconds. Yeah, that's messed up. Yeah, Mark Hamill. You don't know who Mark Hamill is, George? Mark Hamill played Luke Skywalker. But as far as his voice goes, you may recognize him more as the Joker. Like, as far as animated versions of the Joker, Mark Hamill is probably, like, the definitive version. But yeah, rest in peace, Carrie Fisher, and I guess... Yeah, and then the next day... her mother. But, I guess that's how that thing works. I couldn't imagine burying my own kid. Being in the military, I've seen parents do it. But, yeah. I heard her last words were, "I want to be with Carrie," and then she just went.
Why don't you introduce yourself?
Yeah, I was considering buying the Pro. I was raising its pros and cons, no pun intended. But I was raising its pros and I was measuring its pros and cons. Like, should I just get a regular PS4 or go for the PS4 Pro? Because at first I was thinking, I won't bother with a PS4 Pro because I don't have a 4K TV or a 4K monitor, and I don't really have any intentions of getting one anytime soon. But I heard that it does offer some advantages to playing at 1080p as well. Better shaders, a more consistent frame rate. So, maybe. I like the idea of a better frame rate. I'll be honest, I don't care too much about graphics. And that's probably just a product of me growing up in the NES era, is I really don't need good, super, ultra fine graphics in order to enjoy a game. I want it to be playable. To me, good graphics isn't making it look super hyper realistic. To me, good graphics is when you can tell things apart, where things don't blend together because everything's distinct. You had your Wii U from 2015? Graphics can shove it, you're nearsighted. Well, there you go. I mean, I have great vision. I'll get the next one. Yeah, I guess graphics wouldn't do, you know, then that's another thing that I don't really consider is that, yeah, graphics don't mean much if you have bad eyesight. I have good eyesight, but I don't care. I care about performance, not looks. I mean, Final Fantasy 15 could have looked like Super Mario 64. I don't care. I want a good, fun game that I can rely on to run properly. You had a PS4, you cannot fit a lot of games on the hard drive. Yeah. But that's another thing is I'll get like indie games or games that are purely digital download. Like, I know Shovel Knight has a physical release now, but when it first released, it did not. So I have Shovel Knight downloaded. But, if I can get a game on disc, I will. I will, because I don't want, especially like a full AAA retail game, like, I will never get the digital release of something like Final Fantasy 15. That's insane. I mean, as it is, even if you get a disc version of a game nowadays, it still pre-installs a portion of the game on the hard drive, so you're installing something on the hard drive anyway. It doesn't matter. We're no longer in a generation of NES where the story and the gameplay were kings, not the graphics. Well, I mean, you say that, but back in the days of Super NES and Genesis, it very much was a graphics race. It was a numbers game. It was a numbers game. The days of the Super NES and the Sega Genesis, I mean, it, as far as the marketing goes, it was nasty. It was the video game equivalent of the Cold War. You know, it was a numbers game. When the Genesis was very much marketed, at least when it was still competing with the NES before the Super NES came out. The Genesis was marketed because, and it sold well because it had better graphics than the NES. And then they just had to take a new approach when the Super Nintendo came out. They had to market it themselves. They pretty much had to take advantage of the insecurity of teenage boys by marketing itself as the more mature platform. You know, that's why they had Sonic the Hedgehog. It's like, oh, he's got more attitude than Mario. They took their one advantage that they had hardware-wise over the Super NES, and they ran with it, the whole blast processing thing. That's because the Super NES, hardware-wise, trumped the Sega Genesis in every single area, minus one, the processor speed. I believe the Super NES had a 3.6 megahertz processor, and the Sega Genesis had 7.6, so it was faster. When you see the fast scrolling and scaling of a Sonic the Hedgehog game, the way it rotated, scrolled diagonally at the speeds that it did, and they said that you couldn't do it on Super NES, they weren't kidding. You really couldn't do it on Super NES, at least not with the consistent frame rate that it had. as far as do I prefer great gameplay or a great story? Gameplay. I mean, I'm a Final Fantasy fan, and I'll sit here and say this right now. The story of every Final Fantasy game is stupid. It is just stereotypical anime convoluted. Save the world with the power of friendship. Teeny bopper tripe. All of it. But they're fun, so I play them because they're fun games. But I've always thought the story of Final Fantasy games were kind of dumb. Yeah, Trump. I don't know if Trump became a verb before.
How long was I gone?
Donald Trump. I mean, because you've always had that that expression, Trump card. I don't know. It's been around for a while, but bear in mind that Donald Trump is 70 years old, so he's been around for a long time. Telltale Games, you know what? Yeah, Telltale Games, I'll play for their story. There are some games where I'll play for a story. But I already have to be invested in the story. Like, you know, it's hard to say. Point-and-click adventures, because they lack in the gameplay department, yeah, they rely on their story.
I almost didn't hear you
coming. Oh, and here's Volgrim. He's voiced by Phil Lamar. You may remember him as the hyperactive UPS guy from Mad TV.
You're surely not empty-handed. Or this shall be the briefest of introductions.
I've been talking to you guys and kind of playing this on autopilot. Yeah, well, they didn't really use AMD or Intel processors in the Sega Genesis and Super NES, if I'm not mistaken. I can't remember off the top of my head what they used, though.
You'll seek the power behind the one called Destroyer. You will find the answers.
I do know as far as graphics, the Switch is using an NVIDIA processor, which is kind of a new thing for a console.
You aren't even a shadow of your former self. You wouldn't last a heartbeat. Besides, the way to the tower is...
You don't want to see characters like this? I always wonder how they make P and S sounds without lips.
Feed my hunger. And I'll feed your curiosity.
Yeah, like he's saying feed, which requires you pressing your teeth against your lower lip because of the F sound. How is he doing it? Switch is basically the NVIDIA shield, kind of. I will say this, at least they're not using x86 architecture. They're not using Pascal either, which I think they kind of should have, but... Oh well. Then again, I'm not really a hardware or software engineer in that case, so maybe they know some methods to get a little more bang for their buck out of what they're doing. Okay, I kind of forgot what I was doing. Okay, we're trying to get 500 souls for Volgrim, so he feeds our curiosity. You looked it up. Trump was the name of a card game in the 1520s, and the Trump card was a powerful card. Wow, a powerful card. So they had something on par with Magic the Gathering? Well, I mean, I guess it makes sense. I'd imagine in 1520, they believed a lot more in magic than we do now. You take a flashlight back to 1520, most of them will have you burned at the stake as a witch. Come on, blue dragon. Whoa! There we go. Yeah, that's what this thing is called, a blue dragon. Oh, I guess those cars did extra damage to them. Okay, so in this area, we have these fire hydrants right here. There's five or six of them. We want to break them all. How am I doing on health? I'll ignore that green chest right there because I'm good on health. And we'll ignore that thing until later. The Switch has a USB Type-C Thunderbolt 3. They could release add-ons later that have GPU for hardcore... So you're saying the Switch will be available for expansions for users or for devs? Because that's kind of what the Super Nintendo did, is they allowed for RAM expansions from devs. That's why you could get things like the Super FX microchip on the Super NES. You'd have things to push the game past the limitations of the actual base hardware. I am playing this on PC.
We have enough souls to feed Volgrim's hunger. Now, maybe he'll feed our curiosity.
Ooh, you think you're being clever by saying that, but no, he already said that. Oh, okay, so we have like these Legion artifacts. Volgrim will explain them later, but we can We can find them throughout the game and trade them into Volgrim for more souls, which, if you weren't paying attention to the Charred Council's conversation with War earlier in the game, they're pretty much money. When you kill enemies, you'll see different souls pop out. You'll see, like, the blue souls, which are currency. They're money. You see the yellow souls, which are wraith, which are kind of like our magic. Like, you see the yellow meter up there. We have certain spells that use wraith or wrath or whatever you want to say it, like that. And then we have green souls, which are hell.
These ancient gates have a mind of their own, but with this, you may reach
Xbox One.
Beyond the gate, seek out Samael's prison. Once, Samael was close in power to the Dark Prince himself. Some might even say a threat.
Why do you roll your tongue on the R for threat?
To the destroyer. Seek me out.
Certain GPUs and enclosures for Thunderbolts and the taps directly into the PCI Express bus directly. They're like the N64, like the expansion pack for N64. So yeah. So pretty much, it allows for It allows for you to get more bang for your buck out of the console. But my question was, is that for consumers? Like, is there going to be stuff that we're able to add to it in order to make it more powerful? Or are there just workarounds and exploits? Are these things that are available for the devs to use? You know, kind of like with the RAM expansions and compatibility with other different kinds of chips that you could put in cartridges that devs could use. Okay, so we got a new item here. We're just going to stick it in whatever slot. And we use that to open up this gate right here. I'm not going to do that right now because Volgrim is also kind of a shopkeep. He's a shopkeep that we can use to upgrade ourselves throughout the game. There's a few more things that I could get around here, specifically souls, and I'm going to do that. Kill off a few enemies, unveil a hidden chest. Because we have an item that reveals all the chest locations, and as you can see, there's kind of a chest right here according to the map, but it hasn't appeared yet. That's why we have to destroy all of the fire extinguishers around here, or fire hydrants. Then it'll make that chest appear. But I want to buy a few things from Volgrim before we move on, so I want to gather up some souls. Yeah, we can block enemy attacks. A little later on, we'll be able to turn that into a counter maneuver. Right now, it could dock with GPU to boost 4K, maybe VR, or other things. Huh. See, it's weird. Like, because you look at what we know about the Switch's specs, and it seems like it's extremely underpowered. Like, how are they going to get third-party support if it's so underpowered compared to the PS4, the Xbox One? But then, like I said, I'm not really a software engineer, so there could be techniques and other things that I'm not thinking about. So I'm thinking, with the right amount of know-how, this thing could run games that are on PS4 and Xbox One. I wonder if there could be a Switch version of Final Fantasy 15 at some point down the road. I'm not cussing as much as usual because I'm not playing Super Mario Maker, but I have a queue full of levels. I really should probably be playing Super Mario Maker at some point in the near future. I still have levels in my queue. You know what? I looked at my queue a few weeks ago, and the very first level is from Atticus Finchkin. It's from Finch. And that frightens me. Maybe that's what's keeping me from playing it. Yeah, not really cussing much right now. Maybe it's because I'm having some beers and I'm chillaxed. Also, I'm playing an extremely violent game, so I have this outlet. I'm getting out some of those more visceral urges. It's been a stressful time of year. The holidays and all that. And I'll be straight up open and honest with you guys. Yeah, I wasn't streaming much lately because I was having a few personal issues. I mean, this is my first Christmas since my mom passed away, so I was a bit stressed out. But so there's an issue I have with this game. That right there. Go away, car. So yeah, once you've significantly weakened an enemy, you can press the B button in order to do a finisher move on an enemy. But that's also tied to the same button that lets you pick up environmental objects in order to throw them. So sometimes you're getting ready to finish off an enemy because they have that prompt above them, but you're standing right next to a car or a chair or whatever. So you'll go to do a finishing move on them by pressing the B button or whatever button you have that map to, because I'm playing the PC version. And they'll just pick up a thing instead of doing the finishing move. So anyway, we've killed enough enemies with Chaos Eater's sword, so it leveled up and it got stronger. Also, when you go back to Volgrim, he lets you pay to unlock certain abilities for a certain weapon, but some of them are locked behind levels. You got to be up to a certain level with that weapon in order to unlock the move. But, yeah, we got a stronger Chaos Eater sword now. Do I play GTA 5? No, I don't. But you know what? I feel like I should. I haven't played a Grand Theft Auto game since Vice City. And a lot of people are telling me that 5 is a good game to play if you want to get back into the series. And I've watched my daughter play it, and I like Trevor. I'll say that. I like Trevor. He's very funny. So it seems like it has some characters that I could get into. So I've been considering trying it. But every time I, you know, get around to a point where I might want to get that game, either I'm short on cash or I have money and I want to spend it on another game that came out. Yes, I did watch Full House Season 2. Or Fuller House Season 2, I did watch it.
What would you ask of this humble merchant?
Wait a minute. Yeah, I did. I liked it. George, are you saying that GTA... What's looping back to FF plot? By FF, do you mean Final Fantasy? What's looping back? Final Fantasy plot. And no, I wasn't arrested or hooked on drugs. I've never been to jail. I've never been arrested. Oh, yeah. You know what?
On your journey, you may come into possession of certain items that are of particular interest to me. Artifacts of the Fallen Legion. If you discover
back to the past 15 minutes,
Legion
literally,
artifacts, bring them to me.
I don't know what I'm talking about. I ramble. Okay, let's trade in that artifact. I leveled up the Chaos Eater, so I think I'm going to pick up the Scythe. So, the Scythe is a great weapon. It's got this nice wide range as part of its basic combo. It goes in a nice big full circle. So if you're in the middle of a group of enemies, it slices them up. Sometimes it knocks them back. It's got some good distance to it. So, you know, some range. Goes in a nice circle. So it's really good for crowd control. Only real drawback to the Scythe is, it doesn't have the maintained air combos, whereas, it, if you're going for an airborne enemy, it's better to use the Chaos Eater because, you can maintain some air a little longer, whereas with the Scythe, you have that, and it kind of starts out, he swings it downward. I guess if the enemy was behind you, it would help to get a little more air. But, yeah, the Scythe is good for crowd control on the ground, but, it's probably not as strong as the Chaos Eater.
The whole code of my ancestor.
Did it really? Are you sure you didn't accidentally click on the timeline and rewound it a little bit?
Then we are free.
None are free while the Destroyer still breathes.
The Destroyer, yes. To his service we are bound. Though
I'm sorry, but I gotta hold on.
His enemies we call friend. Pass now, friend. Most bring victory. Most bring.
I'd say Carrie freedom. Fisher was a big one. Okay, so in regards to that last scene, I have to say it because I grew up in the 80s.
I can't wait to find out what's behind.
Come on, Mark Hamill, hurry up! Look at this guy just jump. Okay, gotta say it at least once, because I grew up in the 80s, and he reminded me of that scene. They look like good, strong hands, don't they? The nothing came. Yeah, I think of Rockbiter from Neverending Story every time. How am I doing on health? All right, so I'll skip that chest. Huh. That's weird. Nobody else seems to be getting that issue, though. Whoa. I hate these guys. The big fiery guys. They're called Fleck Bursters because they explode. Yeah, so I'm going to be using the Scythe a lot for a while. Because I got the Chaos Eater up to level 2, and I'm gonna be switching back and forth between different weapons unless the situation calls for me to use a specific weapon, because I want to try to get them leveled up. Oh, you're on mobile. See, yeah, I don't watch YouTube on mobile a lot, so I tend not to really account for that. I probably should. I mean, even according to my own analytics, most people who watch me on PC. What are you laughing at? He was laughing at me. Oh god, no, I should have. I didn't have any place to go to the side. He kind of had me cornered there. Oh, run away, run away, run away! It's the holy hand grenade of Antioch. A smart device. Well, a PC could be a smart device. Not stupid. I don't know. It depends. It really depends. If you're watching me on a compact Presario, then you're on a stupid device. But, God. Oh, who remembers compact Presarios? Used to have one of those. That was like my first Windows PC was a compact Presario. Okay, so I know I usually like look at my health bar and say, when I see a green chest and if I'm at full health, I say no. But if you notice, this one's got a black swirl around it and is a little more glowy. So it's not just one filled with green souls for health. It is in fact one filled with a lifestone shard. Collect 4 shards to create a lifestone that will increase War's maximum health. So this is kind of where we get into the whole inspiration from The Legend of Zelda. The lifestone shards are essentially a piece of heart. Once you collect a certain amount, you get a lifestone, which is pretty much a heart container. So that's where this game gets a lot of its Legend of Zelda. That's why, a lot of Legend of Zelda inspiration, because there's a lot of item-based regression in this game. Which would change come Darksiders 2, which has a lot more RPG elements to it. So, okay, we're almost to the Scalding Grounds, I think is what it's called. Scalding Gallo, there we go. This is where Volgrim told us to look for Samael's prison, which isn't subtle with the Christian mythology there. Samael, one of the many names that anybody who's read the Bible has heard. So if you're a religious person, specifically, if you're Christian, this is heavily based on Christianity, specifically the Book of Revelations from the Holy Bible, but they do take liberties with it. So if you are a Christian, bear in mind, this is fiction, not in any way trying to be real, so try not to be that butthurt and offended by it. You're Catholic? Yeah. Nobody's being hanged, somebody's being imprisoned here. But yeah, Samael. You may know Sam, depending on your religion or the denomination of your religion. You could be one of the many branches of Christianity. Samael's gone by many names, like Satan, Lucifer, which is Latin for light bringer. You know? Many, many names. Where's our horsey? You're asking, where's our horsey? Because War is one of the 4 horsemen of the apocalypse. Yeah, he's kind of missing, isn't he? We get him at some point in the game. We do get our trusty horse, Ruin. You look bored. Look at him. He must be so bored. When I was in the military, I stood post just like that guy right up there. Just like this guy right up here. It's promoting the devil. It's not really promoting him. It makes him very much out to be the bad guy. There are things even you should feel. You want to yell at Lucifer, a TV show on Fox, but now, where Lucifer helps the LAPD solve murders.
The Destroyer knows of your coming.
Y'all need Jesus milk.
He moves his legions against you.
By the way, they were speaking some other language, and they both used the word Straga in the context in which they were using it. I'm assuming Straga means warrior. Anyway, this is the Phantom General. And considering the fact that he is apparently a general, I'm wondering Why was a general standing a guard post? That's something you would do with a private. Or, I mean, depending on the post, I guess you could have upward to a gunnery sergeant standing that post. But seriously, why is a general standing a guard post? That bugs the military side of my brain. Why is it? Yeah. Weird. Why? 4K. So, yeah, the scythe is very handy right here because you're surrounded by dudes. So, it's very good for crowd control. Ooh, you thought you'd get the upper hand on me. Will you take my head? Okay, well. Oh, owie? Owie? So, a good strategy with this guy, we have the Earth Caller, the horn that we use to call the Guardian. Ooh. So, wait for him to charge at you, and then just use the Earth Caller on him. Get a few combos in, back away, and then use the Earth Caller again, and you just knock him on his ass every time. So, yeah. You could just kind of keep him in an endless loop. He can't really get up long enough to actually cause any significant damage. I don't think Jake is related to Tony Romo. Maybe he is. I don't know. No, I don't watch Big Time Rush. What was the other show you mentioned? I can't tab out because I'm playing the PC version, so I can't really scroll up. What's the other show you mentioned? But no, I don't watch Big Time Rush because I've heard of Big Time Rush. I think my daughter used to watch it a little bit. But no, I don't watch it. Because that's about a boy band, right? What? Why would I watch a show? Why would I be interested in anything starring a boy band, says the guy who likes Final Fantasy 15? Ridiculousness? No, I don't watch that. And I know I've seen a few episodes of that. Because my oldest boy was watching that. You're right, it really fucking doesn't. Fuck! I'm off my fucking game.
Are you here to play executioner? They should have sent all four of you.
I have no interest in killing you, Samael.
The Destroyer! He's beyond your reach. Beyond
War doesn't look people in the eyes when he speaks to them. Account. He kind of like... with his hood down. That's a sign of low self-esteem.
Perhaps there is a way. But you will need to get inside the Destroyer's spire.
The host is always high.
The tower is guarded by four of his chosen.
No. 15 is not... well, I mean, that's very subjective. Whether or not it's the best, it's certainly not my favorite. Final Fantasy VI holds that title still.
Seek the Twilight Cathedral, where the Bat Queen Tiamat has gone to roost. The whole of her domain is a blistered inferno.
So, we're going to go beat up a giant bat. That's our objective, because we need to get four hearts of the chosen in order for us to gain passage to the Destroyer's tower.
Beating heart.
Yeah, I wouldn't say 15 is objectively my favorite. Okay, so we got a new ability from Samael. We got the Shadow Flight ability, which pretty much is just a little gliding maneuver after we double jump so we can get a little more ground. And my grandson wants a sex robot. So, we have the Shadowflight geyser right there. I was making fun of Rick from Rick and Morty. So we have a Shadowflight geyser right there, which lets us get a little boost when we're using the Shadowflight. That's how we progress to the next area, but we're going to go over here for a few seconds. Final Fantasy 15 looks like God of War imported Final Fantasy. Not quite, no. Not quite. If anything, it reminds me a little more like Kingdom Hearts. I just felt like breaking the fire hydrant there. It doesn't really do anything in this area. But, yes, that is a lot of bottles. Wait, FF0? Wait. What? FF0? What? What's FF0? Is that like... Is that like F-Zero importing Final Fantasy elements? Yeah, this is what I was thinking. I will say this about Final Fantasy 15. I have this bit, like, alright, so here's the thing. I'm not a car guy. I never have been. I drive a Ford Focus, and I'm completely satisfied with my Ford Focus. I just want something reliable that gets me from point A to point B. So I'm not much of a car guy. If anything, my wife is more of a car person than me, considering that she's... You know, yeah, a mechanic. She's more mechanically inclined than me. She has to have a Mustang. Me, I don't care. Yeah, okay. Alright, so here we go. This item right here, I'm getting sidetracked for a little bit. This is the Wraith Shard. Collect 4. It creates an entire Wraith core, which, as you can see, we have kind of like 2 yellow points on our Wraith right there, or Wraith, whatever you want to call it. Magic, that's what I'm going to call it. Once we get a complete Wraith core, it'll add another one right there. But I'm not a big car guy, and no, my dick's not going to fall off. every time I see that, I think of this episode of Aqua Teen Hunger Force where Carl gets like a cup for one of those like contests, and he rips it off and is like, he says, "Tomorrow you'll get your dick ripped off." But okay, yeah, Carl, there's a dead human in our house. Carl, what do you know about this? what the hell was I saying? Oh, yeah. I'm not a car guy, but I do have this very childish kind of list of dream cars, because I think everybody has a dream car, but my dream cars are very childish. Like, for the longest time, I wanted the Ecto-1, I wanted the 1960s Batmobile, and I wanted the Mach 5. Final Fantasy 15 added the Regalia. Yeah, the Mach 5 is from Seed Racer. Final Fantasy 15 added the Regalia to that list, so now there's 4 of them. did any of the people you knew in the military play Mario? Because lots of guys think they're... Actually... Tons of people I knew in the Marine Corps played Mario. In fact, one of our favorite games to play on the GameCube when we were deployed, because I took my GameCube out to Iraq, we played tons and tons and tons of Mario Golf. Okay, so we got a weapon enhancement from Fulgrim. Pretty much just different items that you could allocate to your weapons. Right here we have Weapon Master. Pretty self-explanatory. It increases our attack damage. Alright, I'm going after a thing down here that we got one of them earlier. There's 10 of them in the game. We're about to go after the second one. I didn't really discuss it when I got the first one earlier, but this is the second piece of the Abysmal Armor once we've completed 10. We're not going to get all 10 of them until damn near the end of the game. We get a new set of cool-looking armor that makes us a little more durable. Ooh, I almost let go a little too soon there. The GameCube had an excellent game library. In fact, it was more powerful than the PS2, but the game library is what ultimately helped the PS2 win. It had a much better game library, more diverse. They know what your names are. But, yes, golf. We played tons and tons of Mario Golf. But, nobody in the Marine Corps is afraid of playing a Mario game or a Kirby game, because nobody in the Marine, think about it. A lot of, ooh, I don't want to die. Oh, there we go. Oh, I need to be careful because I'm a, ooh. I need to watch my health. I really need to watch my health. What was I saying? Okay, so yeah, there's a lot of people who play like strictly games like Call of Duty or Madden because they buy a new video game console because they want to show off that they can afford a new video game console, but they don't want to seem too nerdy. So all they really do is play very, very mainstream popular games like Call of Duty or Madden that are marketed as very manly games because they're insecure males and they're afraid that if they play anything, you know, cutesy or colorful, that their dick's gonna fall off, right? But here's the thing. I was in the Marines. So I'll play Kirby, Mario, whatever. I think those are all excellent games and I love them. I really can't stand Call of Duty because from a gameplay perspective, it hasn't changed much over the years. I liked when the Call of Duty franchise was in World War II because I didn't actually fight in World War II, and I think it was a very heroic time, even though you probably aren't going to hear that from any World War II veterans. But, you know, it's a story I'm interested in because I didn't take part in it. But ever since Modern Warfare, the Call of Duty franchise has kind of been a series of 9/11 revenge simulators. But the thing is I was in the Marine Corps. Even if I was insecure in my manhood, I think the fact that I was in the Marine Corps supersedes any video game that I play. So I could be sitting here on YouTube doing fucking puppet shows with My Little Pony figures, but the fact that I was in the Marine Corps would supersede that. I would not lose any masculinity, I don't think. Which, by the way, Rainbow Dash is a fucking badass. Rainbow Dash beat Starscream. Oh, hello. These bat creatures, they're called, what the hell are these characters? I can't remember the name of every enemy in the game. I think these are called Duskwing. Okay, so remember how in one of those areas where we had to destroy all the fire extinguishers in the area in order to unlock a chest? See these cross-shaped tombstones? We are now destroying all of these. Your dick just fell off because you played Mario Maker. Stop playing this and play Call of Duty. You can reattach it. It's all good. Haven't you ever heard that King Missile song? Detachable penis. And then he had a detachable penis, but then he woke up one morning and he couldn't find his penis because, I guess it was at a garage sale or something. I don't know. What? Okay. Well, I do a lot of cussing. Tough shit. I'm not their fucking parents. By the way, if you're a little kid watching this channel, yeah, I fucking cuss. Okay, if you're 12 years old, I cuss. If your parents don't like it, oh, fuck, your parents better monitor what you watch on YouTube. Because the way I see it, they're just words. Yeah, I have my kids right here, and I'm saying bad words, but the way I see it, they know that they're bad words, and they know that what they say in the privacy of the group with their own little friends and everything, whatever, because I was their age once, and I know that little kids, they want to feel all grown up and shit, so they say bad words in front of their friends because they think it's cool. But if you're stupid enough to go around and say the F word in front of your teacher, you deserve to get in trouble. You're fucking stupid. You know it's a bad word. Yeah. Yeah, you know better. You know better than to say that shit in front of your teacher, right? Because no, you know you'll get in trouble. And you know it's a bad word. So if you get in, if you say it in front of your teacher, you deserve to get in trouble.
Why would I say it?
You're 32? Well, you're too young to watch this. Isn't it past your bedtime? Talking to this person who's 32. No, you cannot say the N-word, because, see, here's the thing, fuck, ass, shit, whatever, they're all very versatile words. Nigger was intended for one reason and one reason alone. That word was designed for the sole purpose of hurting someone. So no. No, I do not condone the use of that word. Yeah, I said it once just for educational purposes. But no, you can't go saying that. In fact, it's on my blacklist, so it won't even show up for anyone but me. But yeah, that's a word specifically designed to hurt an entire group of people, so no. No, I will not condone it. Oh, scythe leveled up. Okay, so with my scythe at level 2, I'm now going to move Weapon Master over to the Chaos Eater, and I'm going to use it now. You think me dabbing was the worst? Once again, I dabbed once on stream just to explain visually what it was. Now, to be perfectly honest, I might be a little biased when it comes to the N-word because my little sister is black. So, maybe. But I still see it as, it's not just a cuss word. It is a racial slur. It was designed to hurt a group of people. kind of like Kike. I won't condone that word. Because that's another word that was designed to hurt a group of people. You want to get a little more archaic? Don't say Patty. Don't say Patty. Because that was once used to hurt the Irish. In fact, by some Brits, it might still be. I don't know. Devin's not here. I don't know where Devin is. Probably off doing his own thing. Probably off getting drunk. He's old enough. Yeah, there's swear words, cuss words, whatever you want to call them, and then there's just plain, like, there's bad words, and then there's just words that are bad, because they were never designed with any other intent but to hurt. Whereas the rest of them are pretty much just sentence enhancers. Also, I'd really like to know what nerf herder means. Like, for real? Nerf herder. Every father is a teacher. Well, yeah, every parent is a teacher in nature, not just fathers, but mothers as well. Every parent. All right, so here's the thing. No, my little sister's not adopted. We have the same mother, different fathers. So I guess she's technically a half-sister, but that's just... It's easier to say sister. Because who wants to refer to each other as half-brother, half-sister? I mean, because we have a brother-sister relationship. We're not like... It's not like a Sesshomaru Inuyasha relationship. We actually do love each other. I'm not triggered by the N-word. It's just that it... I mean, like, really? Besides using it, in an explanatory form like I did, I mean, you can't just call somebody that. It just doesn't seem... right. I don't know. It just rubs me the wrong way. But if I hear it in fiction, like if I hear it in Grand Theft Auto, chances are, yeah, I'm not supposed to sympathize with this character. Obviously, I'm supposed to think that this character is a fucking moron. And not really to think very highly of them. So, yeah, I'm not triggered simply by hearing it. Honestly, I think the word should have been used frequently in Bioshock because it would have been more historically accurate. All right, where's the, there should be more of these cross-shaped tombstones. I'm missing some of them. Where are they? Unless I already got the, did I already get the treasure chest and I'm just not paying attention? Wait a minute, there's one. Oh, that just brings up a whole new argument of this is the whole that's not your word, that's our word thing. Now, and I've even said this to my own sister. If it's your word, then why does it only have an emotional response when we say it? Because it seems like it only has any real power when white people say it. you know, which is bad. Which is bad, because I think the best way to remove how hurtful that word, I think the best thing to do with that word is to just like not give it any power. Like, don't get mad when you hear it. Don't get mad when you hear it. But at the same time, don't Disney-fy it either. Like with BioShock, I think BioShock Infinite, because you know, because there were large, like, as far as the villains are concerned, there was a, you know, the villains in BioShock Infinite were white supremacists. I think it would have been more historically accurate in order, it would have been more historically accurate to use that word. No, my sister doesn't really say it, because I don't think she has really much of a reason to. Where was I getting with this? Yeah. Don't pretend that it never happened, because those who fail to know their history are doomed to repeat it. So, I say, for the sake of historical accuracy, if you're doing, like, a period piece, like with BioShock Infinite, yeah, white people definitely used that word in 1912. So, if you're making a video game that takes place in 1912, and your villains are white supremacists, yeah, have them use it. Have them use it. Don't use it now, and remove the power that it has now by trying not to get super, like, you know, try to hold back that, like, primal emotional response from hearing it. Because, you know, when people who use it unironically or in a non-instructional way, when people are using it with the intent to hurt, and they see that it does hurt, and they elicit a response from it, then they win. They win. They got what they wanted, and you're just helping them. But don't pretend that it never happened. If you're an artist and you're doing a period piece on that time, in a time in which that word was commonly used, then don't avoid using it. Have the characters, based on the people who would use it. It would be more historically accurate. Can we talk about Trump or video games instead of this? Let's try to avoid Trump. But we can totally talk about video games. Well, I was talking about video games. I was talking about BioShock Infinite. You were too young to have any kind of political views. Go away. I think we're good. How many souls? Oh, wait. Okay. I was thinking I don't have enough, but I believe I do have some Legion artifacts. I'm done talking about Trump, because I'll be perfectly honest with you. The fact that Donald Trump is going to be our president doesn't really mean much. It doesn't really mean much. I think the office of president is very obsolete. It's an obsolete position. We have an office of president because it's tradition. But we're still very much a self-governed country, and if we don't like what our president is doing, we can fire him. I mean, we elected a president. We don't have a king. Yeah, this game is pretty long, so I'll probably be playing it in segments. They'll probably be, you know, sober segments. I'm just drinking right now because it's New Year, so why the hell not? Alright, I want to level up. Ooh, you know what I want? I want Stone Skid. I love this spell. So, it pretty much ups our defense and our offense. War's flesh hardens, reducing enemy damage and increasing the effectiveness of War's attack. So, yeah. Stone Skin, let's go ahead and put that on a slot right now. Boom, there we go. And, when we use this, while it's active, our Wraith will, slowly diminish, and while it's active, it will up our offense and our defense. So very, very handy. Be so ironic if Trump gets fired. Yeah, because of his old slogan from The Apprentice. Yeah. Yes, it's beer I'm drinking. All right, so we're pretty much done here. Well, we're getting ready to move on soon. We're not going to move on from this area quite yet. I'm going to use the Earth Caller in order to wake up this gate. But before I do that, I have to take a quick bathroom break. I will be right back. Make sure nobody steals my seat. Okay, thanks for waiting, guys. Who's Mason? Who's Mason? No, I'm not gonna just piss my pants. My wife bought me these jeans. I like these jeans. Yes, Mom buys all of my clothes because I have no fashion sense, so I let her dress me.
My
Who's Mason?
Spoke of your coming, but a powerful curse holds me now.
Yeah, there we go, Org.
I cannot help you.
Recycling. It's conservation. Save water. Drink beer. Even though I'm pretty sure there's water in
these
beer.
These servants of the Destroyer walk unseen within the realm of shadow. By their blood we are bound. By their blood shall we be free.
So,
I can no longer move within the Shadow Realm.
George Michael's death got overshadowed by Carrie Fisher's and Debbie Reynolds' death. Yeah. Well, I mean, Debbie Reynolds' death was like...
I will grant
you
the power to see
a day after her daughter. A day. Because for those who don't know, Debbie Reynolds is Carrie Fisher's mom.
What hope have we now
against
the Destroyer's
father? No, I don't have a son named Mason.
Hope will not bring
my sons
freedom.
Are Devin, Gabriel, and Ryan. Devin's off doing his own thing because he's an adult. Gabriel and Ryan are here.
Find where these shadow lurkers hide and kill them all. They can't be that hard to find.
Alright, so... now we have a part of the game that I don't really like, and they do this twice in the game. We have, like, these trial areas where we're looking for these shadow lurkers. So, we're pretty much in the Shadow Realm right now. We have four of these areas that we need to go to, and they take us to an arena, and we'll be facing the gauntlet of enemies, but we have to take them out under certain conditions. We can't just kill them. Well, in some areas, we can just kill them, but... for the most part, there's certain conditions that we need to fulfill. Oh, by the way, anybody wondering why you're called mouth breathers on the viewer count? It's because the Watcher refers to humans as mouth breathers. Okay, so here, aerial brawl. We have to defeat 5 enemies. Sounds easy, right? But we, first of all, have to do it within a time limit, and we can only kill them in the air. So, launch them into the air and just do an air combo. And then there's one. There we go. All right, one more. Four more. Oh, he didn't. You didn't launch him? Why didn't you launch him into the air? Boom, boom, boom. Don't. All right, there we go. So, easy enough. I mean, you're probably going to take a few hits because you got to focus on one enemy at a time. But just launch them into the air. All you have to do is really hold the attack button to do kind of an uppercut motion. And then we have them in the air. Just keep mashing on the attack button in order to do an air combo. And there you go.
Excellent.
Katie. Refresh my memory, I'm having a few drinks. Are you from class? That's a hard choice, Justin. Don't make me make that decision. Don't make me do that. That's a hard choice, man. Don't make me choose. All right, from class, how you doing? Playing some Darksiders. Ringing in the new year. Ringing in an early apocalypse, because this game revolves around the early apocalypse. Katie, don't share too much personal information about me. They already know that I bitch about my in-laws on a regular basis. But guys, Katie knows me from a class that I take. She knows me in person. Katie, don't reveal any personal information. I think I already said that. You have your kids in bed? Why? It's New Year's. Let them stay up. Oh, you have a long day tomorrow. Okay. Alright, so, the condition for the gory end, also pretty easy. We gotta weaken the enemy, but we can't just do a regular kill on them. We have to perform a finishing move on them. We start off with some dusk wings. Now, the good thing about dusk wings is we can jump up and we can instantly finish them off. We don't have to weaken them first. There's actually an achievement that you can unlock. Let me go ahead and open up my... You can't see my Steam overlay because of the way I have OBS capturing. But there's a... What is the... I'm just going to look at the achievements for right now. There's an achievement that you can unlock by killing 5 enemies in a row without touching the ground. And this is actually a really good opportunity to unlock that achievement, because you start off with all of these dusk wings, and I completely failed on that, but oh, there might be more. They only hit the ground once, so I could just get 6 of them. Oh, where are you guys going? They're flying up really high. Oh, well. Oh, they're 2 and 3. Okay, I got a 12-year-old and an 8-year-old right here, so I guess 2 and 3, they're not even really capable of forming up memories of holidays quite yet. Oh, there we go. So yeah, we have to kill 30 enemies, and we have to do it with finishers. So there's often dusk wings that pop up here, so that's a good way to take advantage of that. Okay. I don't think I'm going to play this until midnight, no. But I'm probably going to play until I get the first part of The Chosen. So remember how Semael mentioned the Bat Queen Tiamat? I'll probably go until I defeat Tiamat, and then that might be it. But I will continue playing this game at another point. Though I'm probably going to turn this into, I'm going to be turning this into an actual walkthrough. I just kind of felt like casually playing this and, oh god, no. Okay, I'm doing a stupid thing, and I'm just going to heal because I remember that I have healing items. I'm really not paying attention. Yeah, you'll see less of that in the actual walkthrough. I'm just kind of playing this casually, though. When I do my actual walkthrough, I'll be playing it on Apocalyptic mode, the hardest difficulty. I'm playing on normal mode right now because, well, interacting with the chat. You know, I probably wouldn't survive 2 seconds playing on Apocalyptic. Oh my god. I'm not even surviving that well playing on normal mode because of these blue dragons. I just need one more enemy. There's a Duskwing right there. I'm going to take him out and I will be done with this. The Mandala Effect. Oh, wow. Now, when I... Alright, so when I think about the Mandala Effect, I think more... I like to call it the Berenstain Effect. Or, yeah, because I think more about how there's that massive belief that Berenstain is spelled more like as in the Berenstain Bears, how it's spelled more like Berenstain. But for those of you who don't know, the Mandela Effect is when there's like this mass popular belief that something is one way when factually it is not. And it comes from the fact that there seems to be a large portion of the population who believes that that Nelson Mandela died in prison when factually he did not. He served his time, he got out of prison. He only actually recently died a few years ago. But there's other examples of the Mandela Effect. Like I said, like, and the Angry Video Game Nerd actually pointed this out in one of his episodes, how, with the Berenstain Bears, the popular children's books, a lot of people who grew up reading the Berenstain Bears thought that it was spelt more along the lines of Berenstain, when it's actually spelled the way that you would typically spell the word stain, as in a stain on your shirt. Oh, this one right here, we're just destroying the enemies. We're just trying to do it before the poison kills us, so it's not really all that difficult. Kind of just basically button mashing here. So yeah, that's what I think of when I think of the Mandela Effect. And a lot of people seem to have the belief that the Mandela Effect is the result of somebody traveling back in time and changing history. And that a certain population, like, when the timeline shifted or when history changed, they, like, kept memories of the previous timeline. It's very weird. Another example is how a lot of people believe that the line, "No, I am your father," from Empire Strikes Back was actually "Luke, I am your father." Like, a lot of people even quote it like that. Even the movie, I think it was Tommy Boy and Black Sheep. I can't remember because those two movies kind of get confused in my memory. But Chris Farley apparently spoke into a fan and he was like, "Luke, I am your father." Like, popular culture seems to have a lot of people believing that that's how the line went, when it was actually just, "No, I am your father." He never said Luke's name in that line. Yes, Baron Stain, but I'll be honest with you, I thought it was Baron Stein until someone brought it to my attention, and then I actually looked at covers of the old Baron Stain Bears books, and I was like, holy shit, what happened? It really did feel like everything that I believed was wrong, and then it had me questioning reality for a few seconds. Okay, you know what? Now would probably be a good time for me to be using Stone Skin, because I'm getting hurt really bad here. But this is why I'm going to be turning Darksiders into an actual walkthrough, though, because I do want to show the proper way of playing this game without getting completely clobbered. So I'm going to be using Stone Skin here, so I take less damage. Fortunately, the game is generous, and it does give you chests so you can restore your health and you can restore your wrath. Where? More enemies? Okay, let's restore that wrath now, because I'm almost out of Stone Skin. I'm not even going to bother with the blue dragon, because smaller, more easily killed enemies do spawn. And, there we go, finish him off, and we're done with this challenge. You never heard of the Bear? Well, you're probably too young to remember the Berenstain Bears. I always But I read those books when I was a kid. What about the Oh, you're talking about, Mr. Moneybags or what? Yeah, the Monopoly. I never remember. I've heard about that one, but no, I never thought that the Monopoly guy had a monocle. No, he never did. I think a lot of people may have been confusing him for Mr. Peanut. Mr. Peanut has a monocle. But I love talking about freaky shit. Somebody went back in time and just screwed with the space-time continuum, and that's why you remember it as Baron Stein when it's spelled Baron Stain. But you know what? I've always pronounced it Baron Stain. So I'm actually surprised that one got to me. No, we're not gonna talk about that anymore. Alright, this is probably the one that I should have tackled first, because this one's really easy. Just defeat 40 enemies within the time limit. And we don't get things as strong as blue dragons. Yeah, a lot of people think that we live in a parallel universe because, the popular theory is that somebody at some point traveled back in time, and that when they changed history, a certain population of people from the current timeline retained memories from the previous timeline. Thank you. Oh, I should have countered there. Well, not countered, but blocked. We won't get the counter yet. After this, we'll get the ability to counter. There's a flesh burster over there. I might take him out, but I might not have to. But then again, I might, because he is a nuisance. I am playing like garbage. Probably because I've been drinking, but I've been playing like garbage. Usually I never have to use a healing item like that. Yes, babe. Okay. Yeah. Oh, boy. What's my take on aliens? What do you mean? I have many opinions on aliens. Hey, Pixel King, what's going on, man? Welcome. We're playing Darksiders, ushering in the early apocalypse. Happy Earth Rotation Day. I believe aliens exist. Okay, block counter. Awesome. So we're able to, you know, block enemy attacks, but with this new ability, if we block enemy attacks just right before they land, we can actually automatically counter them, and that actually comes in very handy. I believe there are aliens. I believe that there's other humans besides what are here on Earth, because honestly, I mean, the way we're formed, the way we evolved, it's all a product of mutation. We all adjusted a certain way in order to adapt to this planet's environment. So if there is an Earth-like planet, chances are all of the life on that planet grew in such a way to adjust to the same kind of climate similar to Earth. So, I mean, any planet that's like Earth probably has life that's like Earth, ergo humans. Do I believe in the multiverse? Maybe. That one I don't worry too much about. I think it's possible.
Ancestors praise you.
They look like good, strong hands, don't they?
Still thinking of Rockbiter over here. Oh, and we got the Ravager ability. Okay, so let's check out this enhancement. So any weapon that we equip it to when we use that item, well, when we use the weapon that Ravager is equipped on in order to destroy an enemy, or, well, not an enemy, but environmental objects like cars, chairs, tables, whatever is lying around that's part of the destructible environment, we'll get an increase in the amount of souls that we normally would as a payout. Now, as a passive bonus, no matter what weapon we equip this on, I'm gonna equip it on the scythe just because I'm not using it right now. But that's actually going to increase the damage done by environmental items. So it doesn't matter what weapon we have this equipped on. If I were to pick up a car and throw it at an enemy, it would have more damage than it normally would. Your main goal in life is to be a porn star. Good for you. I'm not gonna judge you. Hell, I mean, Sasha Gray started out as a porn star, pretty young actually. But then that ended up being a gateway for her popularity. She was able to, gain some notoriety, and that helped her sell her book. It managed her, because here's the thing. Sasha Gray's actually a good actress. She's actually an extremely intelligent person. And the fact that she was in porn garnered some very wide range popularity. So people knew her name, they knew her face, so they were willing to consume any product that, you know, she put out there. So, I mean, as a father of a daughter, I'd probably kill her if she was my daughter. Do I think Adam Sandler's a good actor? Yes, I think Adam Sandler is a very good actor. I think Adam Sandler is a good filmmaker. When he wants to be, when he has to be. When Adam Sandler sets out to make a good film, he can do it. But here's the thing. I think that most of the time, Adam Sandler just makes a movie so he and his friends have a chance to get together once a year, and then they just, while they're getting together, they make a film so they can write it off on their taxes. It's like, hey, you know, it, like Adam Sandler's like, hey, David Spade, hey, you know, fat guy from Pixels, I can't remember his name off the top of my head. Let's hang out this summer. Let's hang out. He's like, I don't know. I'm kind of strapped for cash right now. And it's like, no, it's okay, man. Let's just put a shitty movie together, and then we can write it all off on our taxes. Do I like conspiracy theories? Do I like conspiracy theories? Katie, check my channel. I did a full playthrough of a game called Deus Ex. The entire premise of that game is, what if every conspiracy theory ever turned out to be true? Yeah, I like conspiracy theories. I don't necessarily believe in all of them, but I think they're interesting stories. Kevin James, thank you. Yes, Adam Sandler is a great human being. I've met Adam Sandler in person. He's a very cool guy, yes. Seems very laid back and chilled. I mean, I only saw him for... I only interacted with him for seconds, but he seemed all right. You know, you can meet someone and get, like, a vibe off of them. He didn't seem like a dick. When I was in the Marine Corps, I did security for a lot of, event. They took volunteers off of the base for some red carpet events and things like that. Very minor stuff. And, I met quite a few celebrities, in that way. I mean, I wasn't all chummy buddy-buddy with them, didn't go out, have drinks, but I interacted with them for a few seconds, you know. But yeah, that's basically it. Nothing really, you know, I don't have a big story about it. Just, they would take volunteers off of base to work security on certain red carpet events. I ended up working security at Ozfest 2 years in a row. That was pretty cool. I got to go to Ozfest twice for free. And I remember my first time doing that, I was like, oh, this is Ozfest, this is going to be wild. I'm going to be super busy, I'm not going to be able to really enjoy the music or have any fun or anything, but no, nothing really crazy to tell there. Everybody at Ozfest was, for the most part, very well behaved, and now that I think about it, yeah, those tickets are super expensive. People don't want to get kicked out of that event after forking out all that cash. Welcome to 2017. Okay, George, are you on the East Coast? Yeah, but yeah, Happy New Year to everybody on the East Coast, because you're about 2 minutes past midnight now. I'm on the West Coast. I live in California, so still got 3 more hours to go for me. And I'm pretty sure we'd have taken out the Bat Queen Tiamat before then. I have not seen Sausage Party. I kind of want to. I've not. Is that still in theaters? I went and saw Rogue One a few nights ago. The day after Christmas, in fact. All right, Volgrim, you got anything for me? Ooh, wait a minute.
Would you ask of this?
What would you ask of this humble merchant? I think I already mentioned it, but Volgrim here is voiced by Phil Lamar. There's probably tons of other things that I can think of with Phil LaMarr in it. I know he has quite the voice acting career, but to me, when I think of Phil LaMarr, my mind immediately goes to the hyperactive UPS guy, or they called it UBS, from Mad TV, where he'd show up in the brown uniform with the box and be like, "Hey, hey, how's it going? How's it going, man? How's it going? Oh, I got a package for you. Here, go ahead and sign. All right, good enough. All right." You'd be really, really hyper. Okay, let's level up our Death Eater. Chaos Eater. What was I mean? Death Eater. I'm going all Harry Potter now. Come on, Justin. What? Maybe. I'm not gonna give you a link. For free. Hey, Zio Kim, how you doing? Not quite yet for me. I am still on the East Coast, 3 hours away from my happy rotation day. So Earth has made its full rotation around the sun, but it kind of like does this deal while it's turning. So California hasn't made a full rotation. And okay, let's go for Meteor Strike, because that kind of makes it easier to get out. Power Strike, maybe that'll be... Yeah, I could use that. Maybe I did want Sword Uppercut. You know what's good? Flip Saw? Oh, maybe I wanted Harpoon Tackle. I'm not even thinking. Demon Edge. Demon Edge is good, because that carries me into the air as well. I should have gotten Harpoon Tackle. Whatever. There will be another Volgrim location right outside of our next location, so... Not even paying attention. Yeah, Earth has an elliptical orbit, which explains our seasons, not our time zones. But see, what happens is it's going around, but unlike our moon, see here, it's weird. Like, our moon rotates around the Earth, but like, here's the face of the moon right here, and as it rotates around the Earth, it's kind of like this, where the same side of the moon is always facing us. But Earth, so here's the sun, here's the Earth. Earth rotates around the sun, but it's not always the same side facing it, so it's kind of like this. Yeah, you know, it's kind of... Earth is flat. Give me a fucking break. Earth is about as flat as Jody Sweet. Wow, you know what? It's funny the things that the passage of time throws at you. I liked Full House when I was a kid. I really liked Full House when I was a kid. You know what thought did not cross my mind the entire time I watched Full House when I was younger? Is, wow, Jody Sweetin is gonna have some big boobs. But now I watch Fuller House and I wonder, like, I look back and I'm like, wow, I had the hots for DJ? Look what Stephanie turned into, goddamn. Now, don't get me wrong, Candace Cameron is still really attractive. But, yeah, she got beat. You're going to bed right now, Pixel King? Oh, come on. Well, yeah, you're a wee baby. You gotta go night-night. Your parents aren't even gonna give you a sip of beer, huh? you know what? Gibbler. She's okay. She's not ugly. She's not ugly. But I wouldn't go out of my way. I will say this, though. Andrea Barber, She did get better with age, but she's still not what I... She's not like, oh, my God. Like, you know? I was surprised with Jody Sweet. I was very surprised. Yes, I said tits. What? I talk about boobs all the time. All the time. Speaking of boobs, and I asked this question on Twitter and on Discord, but I'll ask it again now because I think the question bears repeating. And it does require, this is a very important question, and I think it does require some deep thought. Baby centaurs, you know, centaurs, the half man, half horse creature. How are they breastfed? How does a mother centaur breastfeed a baby centaur? Do they use the human nipples on the front? Or do they use the horse nipples underneath? This is definitely a question that, you know, begs an answer. Alright, I'm gonna throw this car over at this enemy real quick to repeatedly take down some health. Boom, here. Have a free car. Zero down! Hopefully by the time he gets to me, I won't have to hit him very much. Alright, so yeah, we fought one of these guys earlier. They hit like trucks. Last time we fought this guy, though, we were able to transform into our Chaos Form. That's why I was throwing the cards at him from a distance. I wanted to whittle down his health before actually taking him on hand-to-hand. Baby formula. Yeah, I posted that on Twitter and Discord. The guy who tried to smuggle the can of cinnamon rolls in his butt and it ended up decompressing and popping in his butt. Yeah. Yeah. To me, that's kind of funny and also kind of sad because, you know, I mean, thieves, you know, when I see somebody stealing food, I don't think thief. I think a hungry, desperate person who just wants food. Not why. A chapter of what? I have no idea how to play Happy Dungeon. You just downloaded that and then I don't... Oh, use the other one. Are you playing two player? All right, we'll just wait a little minute, a little while, buddy. I'm not gonna be that much longer. Come on, I'm gonna be a little while. Oh no, I didn't want to. Well, okay. All right, got a beholder key. You probably saw a blue barrier up there earlier. We're gonna use the beholder key in order to unlock it. That's a fun little fact. When you're in the middle of your finisher move animation, you're actually invincible. Nobody would be so desperate for cinnamon rolls that they would shove a can that size up their anal cavity, and you can imagine taking it out with... Oh, God. Yeah, I know it's fake. It's still funny. It's still funny. But, you know, I mean, it's not the first time I've used an old internet meme. Like, Final Fantasy Tic Tacs is an old internet meme.
This way.
It's nothing. Some demon trick.
I know what I saw.
He's right.
Uriel.
It's there, beneath the stairs.
I can't do it myself anymore, Morty. It's too loose.
You can sense it, ancient. From neither the White City nor the Black Depths, something lies between.
I can't be the only one who thinks Uriel is kinda hot.
Slay him!
Yeah, I know how to do it. Okay. So, we got kind of a Star Fox section here. Except I'm actually able to use the right stick to control the targeting reticule, which should have been an option in Star Fox Zero. Barrel roll. Use the boost to chase them. Trust your instincts. Heavy hair. Well, no. That was Slippy Toad that I saw earlier. Peppy, yeah. Oh, God. Nah. You know what? That whole peppy hair mission in Star Fox Zero, you know what I mean? I know they meant well, but also hearing do a barrel roll every time you do a barrel roll is very annoying. It also doesn't make any sense that Peppy would say do a barrel roll when he himself is doing a barrel roll. You'd think he would just save that for when he is instructing a person to do a barrel roll. Oh, by the way, this flight section right here, there's actually an achievement that you can unlock for killing 160 enemies. It's not that hard to do, though, because we're going to run into a large, very tiny enemy swarm where you can lock onto several enemies at once and just take them out that way. Were there 8 seasons of Full House? I thought there was 7. Oh, no. No, I know it was on Netflix. Actually, yeah, there were 8 seasons, weren't there? See, I watched the show back when it was on TV. I never really bought any of the DVDs or anything. Ah, shit. Ah! No, it was on Netflix. Full House was on Netflix for a while there. I don't know. I don't think it is. I don't think it's on there now. Speaking of Netflix, there's some good anime on Netflix. Like some of the ones that they get the, where Netflix gets the license for the official dub. Netflix licenses some good anime. Like I was watching Ajin. Ajin is a, like, if you have a Netflix account and you want a decent anime, I would say Ajin. It's weird. It's an anime, but like the dub is so good. Like, it almost seems as if it was animated for English. and not simply dubbed over. But I recently finished watching Aji and it was really good. I also watched Seven Deadly Sins. I'm wondering if there's a second season of that, because season one kind of ended on somewhat of a cliffhanger. Now, I have not played Omega Boost. And I never watched Making a Murderer, but I've heard tons and tons of things about it. Good things. I've heard good things about it. I've also heard bad things. Like, I heard, like, it can make you hate cops. Which, I don't know, because I have some friends who were cops. Hey, JC, what's going on? Welcome. Oh God, giant bat. All right, I'm just gonna take tiny pot shots at this thing and just kind of move to the side whenever it fires. Or, you know, get hit in the face. Whatever works. But these large enemy swarms right here, really concentrate on these things if you're trying to go for the achievement where you kill 160 enemies in this area. Someone's hitting on you. Well, good for you. About corrupt cops, wait until I'm at a moment where I can take a breather so I can read that properly and not respond to it out of context. Okay, this should be the end of it. Those couple of corrupt cops should not get respect like they do. Were they corrupt? Yeah, I'd imagine they are corrupt, because I didn't watch Making a Murderer, but from what I understand, it's pretty much about how the legal system can twist facts in such a way to where they can make an innocent man look like a criminal if they want.
Guess she wasn't up for having visitors today.
No, I guess Tiamat wasn't up for having visitors. I can't help but feel like Mark Hamill is maybe phoning it in for this performance. I mean, it's not his best work. He's noticeably using the Joker voice, but then again, he uses the Joker voice for every piece of voice acting that he does. I mean, even when he's playing the Trickster in the live-action Flash TV show that's currently on, he's using his Joker voice, which doesn't sound right in live-action, because I can't imagine a person actually talking like that in real life. But he's using the Joker voice here. Oh god, what was the name of the villain in Grandia 2? Because Mark Hamill did the voice of the villain in Grandia 2. And he used the Joker voice for that. I can't remember, because I haven't played Grandia 2 since the Dreamcast, like, friggin' years ago. I should have gone for that whirlwind combo. I got Flipsaw. Flipsaw is good. I like the Flipsaw maneuver. That right there. That does a lot of damage to aerial enemies. Yeah, you know what? I probably should watch Making a Murderer. I don't know, because I know that there's corrupt cops, but I don't know. It's probably just my military experience. I can't hold an entire group of people accountable for the actions of a few. I just can't do it. Everything from cops to Muslims, because of my experiences, I mean, I can't do it. Skips. Who skips? Okay, I haven't watched the regular show. What are you doing? This isn't a political stream. At least it's not intended to be. This is just a talk about whatever you want to talk about stream. You boys break that Xbox One, those Xbox One controllers. No, Justin, I cannot. Or I would not. I'm completely capable. I refuse. I actively refuse. Australian Shepherds. I have a German Shepherd. They shed year-round. They don't stop. It's awful. Because they have an Xbox One. They're probably playing Minecraft or something. I haven't watched regular shows, so I don't know about Skip. Mark Hamill is on regular show. I mean, I'd imagine. Mark Hamill gets a lot of voice acting. Kind of like Troy Baker. Troy Baker's in everything. Troy Baker is in this game. In fact, there were two characters that we saw in the prologue that he voiced. Because he voiced Abaddon, and he also voiced Straga, which is the giant thing that we fought in the prologue. The giant thing that we fought, and then he crushed war in his hands. Oh, let's take it that. Yeah, I'm gonna take care of these dust wings. Pitbull. Your Pitbull got your sister's dog pregnant. They were such a cute mix. We call them Australian shit. Oh, I can't remember. Who's that? Katie, who's that dude in class who breeds the pits? Got that dude in class who breed those beefy looking pits. He's always showing pictures of us. He's always showing pictures of them to us. Can't remember his name. So bad with names. Okay. This is our version of bomb flowers in this game, and we have these red crystals that can only be destroyed with bombs. So there you go. Boom. How am I doing on health? Sure, why not? I'll open the screen chat. His girl dog looks like a potato. Yes. He was being kind of gross about it last time. He was showing me pictures of like, oh, this is how we check if a female dog is in heat. And he showed me a picture of a bloody Q-tip. And it was like, dude, for real? I mean, like, I want to talk because, you know, when we're in class, Kelly's always talking about how she's like, Mike, I can always visualize the things that you're saying in my head. I'm playing a PC game right now, Justin, so I can't I can't tab out to look at things on Twitter. Oh yeah, the artificial insemination. I'm like, dude, how? He's talking about I extract semen from a dog. I'm like, dude, you're there's no way around it. He's jerking off a pit bull. How do you, I can't think of any other way other than something very similar to a breast pump, but for a dog's penis. It's how? No. All right. So Katie and I know this guy in class who breeds dogs, and he was talking about artificially inseminating, specifically pit bulls. He breeds pit bulls, and he sells them. Sells the pups. Oh, by the way, the thing I just got is the map. It reveals the map. If you've played The Legend of Zelda, you know what the map does. But yeah, he artificially inseminates pit bulls. But to do this, he has to extract semen from a male dog. And, well, I don't know the technicalities, so I fall back on my very, very vivid, very immature imagination. But my god. Yeah, it's like the scene from Van Wilder, except nobody's eating it. Oh god. That's it. You just reminded me of that scene from Van Wilder, yeah. All the gross shit that I've seen in my life, and that still makes me gag. So, yeah, he was very confident talking about it, too, like, in such a, like, I'm extracting the semen from the dogs, and I'm like, I revert back to the 13-year-old in my head. Just, you know what I thought of? I don't know if you watch South Park, but if you watch South Park, the Red Rocket dog, Red Rocket, that's what I'm thinking of. It's just, oh, God. And it's just, like, okay. What I thought was funny, Katie, is that, like, Kelly was showing, like, an active interest in the conversation, and I'm like, really? All the shit that I say, where you call me out on being, like, too much information or gross or how you can visualize what it's like, I guess just anything that deviates from my constant rambling about my in-laws, you know? I mean, wait, is there another? Okay. Alright, so this is a very tricky Legion artifact, because you can't really angle the camera in any way to where you can see it. Oh, no, I guess you can. But I guess unless you actually angled the camera that way, you wouldn't know it was there. So, yeah, there's a Legion artifact just floating in the air right there. Go ahead and grab it. You don't have to get exactly, but if you get close, it'll kind of attract towards you. But okay, Ryan, don't be rude. Yeah, I tell people about my channel. That's how Katrina or Katie, I call her Katie. That's how she knows about my channel. She knows me in person. Oh, yeah, George, I see you. I get a little mixed up, George. Sorry. Like, George, I see you all the time in other streams. So I have, like, a hard time remembering if you've been to one of my streams or not. What was this about my I'm a married man. Of course I bitch about my in-laws, especially when they're especially as stupid as mine. I don't want to be too loud because we all share the same house, and I really don't want to deal with them right now. But yeah, Katie knows all about me bitching about my in-laws because it's like my thing. It's the thing that I do. Hey, see you again. No, they live with us. They live with us because they are old and have no marketable skills, but they are my wife's parents, so we have an arrangement. I don't murder them, and I get to continue having sex with the woman I married. Okay, this room right here, you can see that we have kind of a locked gate right here. We're actually going to end up back in this room a little later on once we gain the ability to unlock that door. Yeah, 2011. So, 5 years? 5 years. Oh god, almost 6 years. Almost six. Like, oh, almost a console generation. Not for me, George. Not quite yet. Not for another almost 2.5 hours. I live in California, so it's 9:37 right now for me. No. It
7 months because it was July. Yeah, July of 2011. Oh, you know what? Hold on, because what is this? Greater life essence? It seems a little overkill, but I guess I'll equip it to that slot because I already used up the other one, which I usually don't have to use up health items so early in the game, but I wasn't paying attention. I got a little low on health during one of those Shadow Realm trials. Whoa, okay. All right. I think I might need a new HDMI cable. My video gave out on me, but it looks like you didn't actually lose your guys' speed. I just kind of lost my signal to my monitor up here. My TV. Because I'm playing on seeing my big picture mode. Would I rather be a lonely fat ass? Wash myself with a rag on a stick? Probably not. The ice? Did you get Jack and Coke? Oh, did you get alcohol of some variety? Okay. My wife is drinking now. I'm going to, deny any possibility that might be my fault. Do I know the old TVs with built-in VHS? Absolutely, because when Gabriel was very, very, very little, he discovered all by himself
you better come when I call.
Okay, wife. He's pushy, isn't he? He discovered at a very young age that a peanut butter and jelly sandwich fits very well in a VCR. And the VCR that he inserted his peanut butter and jelly sandwich in and mushed it all the way back and got it all, like, embedded into the heads of the VHS player. Yeah, this was a combination. This was a combination TV, VCR, and DVD player. So I lost three things that day. So, yeah. It's adorable. But also, that is the day that I discovered that it is perfectly natural for a parent to fantasize about murdering their own child. Hey, KTG, what's going on, man? Not big. I'd say it was a 15-inch. It was in his room. Oh, this is tricky. Okay, so we have a plant. We have a plant monster up there, and it's drooling green acid. Now, you can probably predict what would happen if I attempted to grab that sword, because that is a sealed door right there, and we want that angel statue to hold the sword, kind of like what we saw earlier in this area to unlock that door. We want this sword right here. Now, you probably know what will happen if I attempt to grab that sword, but for instructional purposes, since I haven't already shown it off, let's see what happens. Oh, it goes all nom nom and I have to mash the B button in order to escape. Okay, so that's not going to work. I can't grab the sword. But I have a Darksiders equivalent of the bomb flowers right here. So let's go ahead and duck one up there. And when it explodes, that plant monster is temporarily, keyword temporarily, stunned. So after you grab the sword, you do want to immediately dash out of the way. Shut up, mouth breather. So, another Iron Knight right here. I want to take out the plebs first. Because they're insignificant. They are his inferiors. Come on, come on. Yeah, here. Backseat, Proby. Backseat. I'm going to slap you upside the head like Leroy Jethro Gibbs. Good work, Abs. Nobody gets the reference. Nobody gets the reference, Mike, because they're not an old person like you. They don't watch NCIS. They're just regular young people. They're not crazy. They don't talk to themselves. I smacked the bomb. As someone who has dealt with high explosives, you'd imagine that I would know better than to strike a bomb with a sword. I don't. But then again, I don't imagine I would ever be allowed to approach any kind of explosive, be them high or low, under the affluence of alcohol. But then again, I work for the United States Marine Corps, so who the fuck knows? Anyway, we got some red crystals over here, and we got some splodiness right here, so we're gonna end. Let's just throw it. Let's not, because I couldn't get the targeting reticle positioned correctly in time. There we go. Let's not be like one of the space pirates from Metroid Prime 3, who they all died from the same thing. I mean, you'd think because they were on board a ship loaded with Metroids that they'd have died from Metroid degradation. But no, once you analyze all of them with your scan visor, you discover that each of them died from holding a grenade too long. Which... yeah, that's just sad. Yeah, rule number 6 is don't apologize. It's a sign of weakness. I'm gonna finish up this dungeon. Alright. Yeah, that's rule number 6. Never apologize. It's a sign of weakness. How many rules does Gibbs have? I find myself, as I grow older, quoting Gibbs whenever I wake up in the morning, because it's harder for me to sit up in the morning, and I wake up and I'm groggy and I'm weak and I'm succumbing to my increasing age, and then I just sit up. I sit up, right? And I'm like, and I do a full sit up in order to, you know, wake myself up in the morning and get out of bed. I do a sit up, and then I look down and I pat my stomach and I'm like, good work, abs. That's good work. Backseat, Proby. Another Legion artifact from Fulgrim a little later on. Open the door. There we go. So, oh yeah, he added Rule 53, which is sometimes you're wrong. But yeah, my wife has actually been, you know what, it's weird. NCIS was my mother's favorite show. And her favorite character was Anthony DiNozzo, played by Michael Weatherly. And when Michael Weatherly left the show, she said, oh, I don't really see the point of watching NCIS anymore. And then she died before season 14 started. So I'm like, well, I mean, she didn't really want to see the new episodes because DiNozzo's not on the show anymore. But then my wife started watching the show, and then I started getting into the show, and then I started to really like it because it's surprising that I never really watched NCIS a lot before, because I was in the Marines, and the character of Gibbs was in the Marine Corps. Not to mention that NCIS itself is a spinoff of JAG, which starred, what was her name? Oh my god, I can't even remember. She was really hot, which made most Marines go like, there's no fucking way she'd be a lieutenant colonel in real life because she's way too goddamn, you know, attractive and young, because most people aren't lieutenant colonels at that age. I can't remember her name. No, I don't watch The Walking Dead. Where was I? Yeah, I'm surprised I just didn't watch that, because I watched JAG, and NCIS is a spinoff of JAG. Ooh, we're gonna get a new weapon here. NCIS is on Netflix, yes. 13 seasons. Season 14 is currently airing on CBS right now. Which I imagine you can catch the last five episodes, the most current five episodes, on CBS's website. So, yeah, we have the, we have a new weapon here, the crossblade, which is pretty much, if you played any, if you played the Wind Waker or, Twilight Princess, it's the boomerang. It's the boomerang. You can even lock on to up to five targets at one time. The autopsy doc. Oh yeah, the autopsy doctor, Ducky from NCIS. You're talking about Ducky. He's played by that British guy that's in everything that I can't remember the name of. Okay, so we got this poison demon right here. You notice when he first arrived, he had a poison gas. He had a green cloud of poison gas around him. You can actually neutralize that by throwing a fully charged crossblade at him. And then you go in for the attack, but you do want to steer clear once you do finish him off, because he explodes, and if you're anywhere around him when he explodes, you're gonna get poisoned, and it does what you would expect poison to do in a video game. It
throw that fancy saw blade around a bit.
It gradually damages you. So yeah. You use the item that you just got in a room to escape the room. That's very Zelda. Ducky, because his name is Donald Mallard. Donald Duck. So yeah, they call him Ducky. But here's something crazy about NCIS, even if you're currently watching it. Polly Perrette, the actress who plays... Abigail Shudo, Abby, you know, the gothic ME, she's pushing 50. It's weird. It's weird. That's Hollywood makeup for you. Alright, let's blow up these crystals. Ah, no, lock on. There we go. She is currently 47. I remind you of Forrest Gump throwing out my life story. You talking about me? You talking about me? Life is like a box of chocolates. It doesn't last as long for fat people. Okay, tutorial, fine, I know. Okay, so what that tutorial page was trying to tell us right there is that we can lock on to a flaming source because these are, bomb rocks right here aren't aflame, so hitting them won't do anything, so we have to catch them on fire. So what we can do is, using the crossblade's ability to lock onto multiple targets, we can lock onto this flame first, and then lock onto the other things, and then it'll use the fire, and it'll take the fire, and it will, set those other things aflame, which is where, I guess the crossblade is covered in kerosene? I don't know. Okay, oh, wait a minute. I want to go this way. There we go. My finger doesn't, though it looks like it had... What? What about my finger? What about my finger? Oh. Wait, Forrest Gump was... What about Forrest Gump was, took place in the Mandela effect? Is there a line there that everybody remembers a different way than what it was actually said? Mama always said, life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. Box of chocolate lines. How does it actually go? I remember life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. How did the line actually... Is that the wrong way to say it? Well, yeah. Well, I know. Well, yeah, I just said it the way, but minus the mom always said. Mama always said, life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're gonna get. Life was like a box of chocolates. Okay, what was, is, eh.
So that's the difference is between is and was. It makes more sense to say is, I mean, really. I mean, because you can't really speak about your own life in past tense unless you're a ghost. So, yeah, we gotta create a chain of bombs here. So once we hit that, it ignites this one and this one and this one. Well, you pretty much see where it's going. Go ahead and yuck one over there just for a little later. Yeah, is and was pretty much is talking about tense, though. I don't think it's as drastic as the spelling of a word or, or, like, mistaking, like, an actual name for the word no, like, with a lot of people saying, like, Luke, I am your father, when he never said that. He said, no, I am your father. What about Zio Kim's finger? No, no, I really don't want to. Guys, just a reminder, I am playing a PC game, so I can't really interact with my chat or OBS or anything, because my mouse is kind of locked into this game. I would have to tab out. Ooh, that sounds painful. I once had a pencil lead in the palm of my hand when I was about 6 years old. It sucked. But I try not to complain about it too much, considering that I'd imagine it pales in comparison to some other pains. Like having your ass broken in half and then having it screwed back together. That happened to me once. It sucked. It still sucks. Even to this day, it's very cold and rainy outside, and I can feel it in my butt. And is there snow? Is it snowing? A little bit? Cool. So, this thing stops rotating once you solve the puzzle. So, once upon a time, I had my ass broken in half. Specifically, I had my sacrum. I had my pelvis fractured in half at sacrum, which is the part of the pelvis that houses the tailbone. And now I have a screw drilled through my pelvis that fused the two halves back together, but there's still metal currently in there. So whenever it's cold or rainy or there's bad weather, I get that pain right there. But because it's in the part of my pelvis that houses the tailbone, it causes a signal to be shot up through my spine and out to the rest of my body. It's wonderful. So on rainy days like this, I medicate. What? And then my wife looks at me like, I gave birth to children. You're a bitch.
can cuss in all of my videos. Do I have to cuss? Do I cuss in all of my videos? Does my butt conduct electricity? Maybe. I don't know. Ask me later. Tonight I'll shove a Nintendo up my ass, and then I'll let you know. There we go. I thought so. I can't remember the names of these guys. They're like Duskwings, but they're on fire. Kind of like how you have your regular keys and your fire keys in Zelda. Okay. You once had a doctor take a screw and put it through your heel, and then a few months later, through the other, you also pulled out your... Ooh, no anesthesia? Oh, by the way, just a fun little fact. Do you see this targeting reticule? You see this targeting reticule? All right. So you see how it's got the circle and then it's got the dot? Now, I had to wait for a patch for them to fix this, but when they first released this game, the entire targeting reticule was the size of that dot in the center. So, that was very frustrating to aim stuff. Never had any bad injuries, Justin? Well, I don't wish any on you. Alright, here's another sword. You probably saw earlier, there's this central platform that we have to stick three swords and three statues in order to progress. Why would someone want to take marrow samples from my pelvis? Aren't there better places to take bone marrow samples? I've never had to take a bone marrow sample, so I don't know. I mean, I would gladly donate bone marrow to anyone who needed it, but... I don't know. Is that where they take it? I know Katie has some, if she's still here, she has some, education in the medical field. Wow, you know what? I'm looking at that and I'm like, the textures are really nice in this remastered version. I'm dead. Well, that was fun. Now we gotta go up and around again. Do one of my kids need a thing? Was it Devin or Alexis? What does he want? Power cord for what? I don't have it. Oh, how does he expect me to get it to him? Okay. Can I walk? Yeah, I can walk just fine. I can climb ladders, I can crawl. It's just cold days screw with me. Good, I think that's all of them. There we go. Yeah, everybody has made the screwed in the ass joke already. My family made the screwed in the ass joke. Got a Wraith Shard right here. This Wraith Shard right here, it's in plain sight. It's marked on the map. One playthrough, I missed it, and it bugged me. Like, toward the end of the game, I was scouring the entire game world looking for the one Wraith Shard that I missed. The IRS never screwed me. I'm fortunate enough to have never been screwed by the IRS. Why am I at this door? Whatever. Huh? Did my in-laws laugh at the screw? Not really. No. Go, 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 there we go. Maybe, if they laughed at me in private, then they laughed at me in private, I wouldn't know. Okay, so we have a thing here, we turn a crank, it raises the platform, but empty space right here where it looks like another crank like this may go, but it's not there, so we have to go into this door and go further down. And here we face another mini boss. Two more hours. At least 48, 1 hour and 48 more minutes, because it's 10:12 to me. Okay, mini boss right here, the jailer. You see those yellow glowy spots on him? Let's hit them with the cross blade, and then let's go in and beat him up. And then move away really fast, because he's going to start swinging his little cage thing and destroying all of his little underlings. Oh god, don't get hit, don't get hit. There we go. Oh, I thought someone was knocking on the door, but when the dog scratches herself, she like thumps on the ground and it's really loud. So I think someone's knocking on the door. Move away. Right, one more cycle like that ought to do. Come on, walk on. Get onto the yellow things. Get onto the yellow things. There we go. Ah! There we go, awesome. How much longer? Oh, yeah, Wisdom's got a point. What, are you tired? I'm gonna stream until we defeat the boss of this area, because if you remember, Samael, when we woke him up from his prison, said that if we want to access the Destroyer's Tower, we have to collect 4 Hearts of the Chosen, so he sent us here to the Twilight Cathedral to get the first one from the Bat Queen Tiamat. So that's what we're here to do, and we'll be done after we've defeated the Bat Queen Tiamat. And then we'll be probably ending the stream there, because I think that's a good place to stop, you know, going and getting the first major plot MacGuffin of the game. Like, it's past my bedtime. My mom and dad are gonna yell at me. All right, let's go ahead and put one of these dormant bombs here, and one over here for a little bit later, but let's go ahead and light this one for right now. All right, and we're gonna get a few soldiers here, but we're also gonna get one of these poison demons, so let's concentrate on him. Let's use the crossblade on him, get rid of that poison gas. There we go. Awesome. Alright, want to steer clear of him, because when he pops like the gross green zit that he is, he does spread a slight bit of poison gas, and we don't want to get poisoned. Okay, so let's go ahead and light all these torches, because they do unlock a thing for us. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There we go. We can lock onto 5 targets at one time. We do want to light all of these torches. They unlock a thing. Not really required to progress, but, you know, I figure if I'm going to play this game, I might as well go and unlock everything. Where are all the big guys, Hunchback? Yeah, because they probably can't sustain their own weight. Also, they're all mutants and gross. Let's get our crossblade ready, because, yeah, there's like a big fiery Duskwing over here. I can't remember these guys' names. I know they have their own name. It's not fiery Duskwing, but they're like the Duskwings, but they're on fire. All right, one more torch to unlock. Is that the last one? I thought I lit that one. Okay, what I really want to do here is blow open that path. We just unlocked that chest, which is an extra goodie for us, but it's not really required. Although it is kind of handy what we're going to get in that chest if you want to use it. But anyway, you probably remember that last floor we were in with that one switch that I said would raise the platforms. Now we have 2 of them, which will raise both platforms so we can make our way across once we get back up there. But that didn't go unnoticed, so of course we're going to have to deal with some more enemies. Level up Chaos Eater. Let's go ahead and move the Weapon Master over to the Scythe. We're going to be using that now. Move Ravager over to the Chaos Eater. Start using our Scythe a bit more so we can level that up. Go ahead, get rid of the poison there. Oh, that was kind of quick.
Wow, it's almost like Scythe was a little bit stronger, but not quite. Can I finish the game in one sitting? Probably. Maybe. I would need to sit a whole day aside, though, because, I mean, it's roughly a 10-hour game when you know what you're doing. Oh, that item that I got right there, that's the Bloodthirst. Leeches weapon damage and converts it into health. So pretty much when you have that equipped to an item, whenever you use that, when you have that equipped to weapon, whenever you use that weapon on enemies, you regain health. So it's actually pretty handy. You know, if you're in situations where you're dealing with enemies that deal out a lot of damage, or you're low on health, then you can just simply, you know, replenish your health through combat. But yeah, I think I could finish the game in one sitting, but it would have to be a day where I had literally nothing else to do. Finish these guys off when they're in the middle of charging their fireball attacks. Alright, that should do it. Okay, remember how we went to a little area earlier and I noted a locked gate and said that we would arrive at that area earlier? Yeah, we actually have been here before. We arrived through that door. And then we were encountered with some enemies and we unlocked a beholder key in a chest right here, which has since despawned. But we've been here before. So in case you're wondering which door you need to go through, just remind yourself that this was the one that's locked with the crystals. And we've already come from there earlier. So this is the obvious way to go. Especially if you have the map, then you could just simply open up the map and notice that, you know, we've been to these areas before because they're not grayed out. Switch the camera over. You can see that there's a crystal sword right there, but it's, you know, we're not really going to be able to grab it right now because we're a little bit occupied right now. Note that there is a green chest right there and a yellow chest right there if you want to refill health or wraith. And we're not exactly done here. Got another poison demon. Fortunately, these poison demons are kind of sloth-like, so yeah, you're really not going to have a hard time avoiding their attacks. That should do it. Let's go ahead and grab the crystal sword. Oh, but of course they weren't going to make it easy. We have two iron knights to deal with right now. I think now would probably be a good time. Camera angle really only allows us to deal with one at a time. Now would probably be a good time to activate stone skin in order to get that extra attack power and defense. Because, The second Iron Knight is going to be able to attack us from off-screen most of the time. we're getting a little low on Wraith now. Let's go ahead and hit up this yellow chest. Okay, now we're just down to one, so now we can conserve by deactivating Stone Skin for a while. Probably should have dodged that. Well, there we go. Alright, got the Crystal Sword out of the way. By the way, you see the Crystal Sword on their back, which makes you think that you're using something different from the Chaos Eater, but it's purely aesthetic. When you're using your sword, it still uses the same attributes as the Chaos Eater, as if you were to actually be using it as a sword attack. Hey, Big Nathan, what's going on? How do you blindfold a Chinese man? Oh, God. You got me. You got me. With a shoelace? Oh, that's not right. It's funny. It's funny, and I'm laughing on the inside, but that's not right. All right, but this is the last crystal sword. We're getting actually pretty close to the boss of the area. If I wasn't jumping directly into lava and dying. Camera angle didn't want to work with me. What the hell? I jumped all the way back. Jumped all the way back when I didn't need to. I thought I was on the other side when I was actually on the side that I needed to be on. Okay. I'm waiting for the punchline. I'm waiting for the punchline. Joaquin. See, I'm not getting it because I, I'm not, yeah. Okay, all right. My wife is giving me the signal to wrap this up soon, so I'm probably going to have to wrap this up soon. Katie. All right, first of all, Zio Kim. I know Katrina in real life. Like, I know we're in person. We go to class together. So try to be a little lenient, but at the same time, Katie, I try to curtail the racial jokes in my chat, okay? I try to avoid that kind of humor. All right? It's just that Zio Kim here is one of my moderators, as evidenced by the fact that she has a wrench next to her name. So I had a reminder that, you know, you and I know each other outside of YouTube. So, you know, she might ban you from the chat or time you out on it. I know you're not racist because, you know, I've met you, but I try to curtail that kind of humor. Like, on my channel. No, it's cool, Katie, it's cool. In fact, if you look at the description of my video, the description that I usually have, there is a set of rules there, which most people find kind of humorous.
still... Oh, you... Fuck. See, I don't... For some reason, I'm thinking very Hebrew when I see that word, and I'm thinking of Joaquin. I'm looking at it as Joaquin. I don't know why. Okay, so we put the three swords in the statues. The platform rose up. There's no way to make it go down, so we're gonna have to go. We're gonna have to go like a really roundabout way if we want to go back down. This way enters towards the boss. If we go into that, it will close the doors behind us and the game will auto-save. So it's kind of a point of no return as far as this area is concerned. So before we do that, there's a few things that I want to backtrack for. Alright, we have the crossblades right here. Let's go ahead and get rid of that thing right here. Stun it real quick so we can make it through this door. The few chests that we have before we move on to the final, not to the final boss. Joaquin, yeah, there you go. For some reason, I was thinking very Hebrew. I saw that and I saw Joaquin. Okay, we got a Wraith Core right there. Not a Wraith Shard. We still have a few Wraith Shards to go to make a full Wraith Core, but that's a full Wraith Core right there. And so, we're able to use a little bit more magic. So let's go ahead and use this, Shadow Flight Geyser in order to make our way back up. And in this chest, we get our third piece of Abysmal Armor. Alright. Not quite done yet. There's something in this area that we can get right now. Actually, no, it's not a thing that we can get right now. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Okay, not here. Not here. Let's go through another door. Go through another door. Not that one. Not that one. Where the hell was I headed? Where the hell was I headed? This door right here? Yeah, this door. I'm gonna head through this door. Shadowflight Geyser to get up all the way over here. And, no, that's not where I wanted to. Alright. Alright. There's something I wanted to grab here. One final chest, even though it doesn't mean much. Huh. Oh, I know where it is. Okay, okay. It's this away. Where is it? Where is it? There we go. All right. All right. Going a little bit up and around. Now, this isn't a thing that you absolutely need. It's just a thing that I kind of wanted to show off. You know what? My conversation. I just thought of a very cruel, cruel joke that I don't want to repeat here. Alright, let's go ahead and blow that up. And glide across. Couldn't get this without the crossblade. And by the time we're able to come back here with the crossblade, it's kind of too late. I mean, I guess it's not so bad if you already know where everything is. But we actually got one of these earlier when we went into the, toward the beginning of the game. We got a Horde Seeker, which reveals the location of all of the chests in the area, which for the most part, we got every single one of them. So there's really nothing that we need to backtrack for. Ugh. What's rule two? Are we still talking about the rules of Leroy Jethro Gibbs? All right, we're almost done here. At least for like the first part of the game, getting that first heart. Well, we got the map earlier, but this is kind of the compass where it shows all of the chests. So yeah, the map is the map. The Horde Seeker is the it's the compass. Okay, so this is the Bat Queen Tiamat, and she has some weird bat boobies on her. Which is interesting, considering the fact that Tiamat here is actually voiced by Lonnie Minella, who was the voice actress for Rouge the Bat, who was also a bat in the Sonic series with bat boobs. So, Lonnie Minella has voiced two bat characters with bat boobs. So, yeah, that's kind of weird. Okay, so she starts out by hurling fireballs at us. She does three of them. Just kind of dash out of the way unless you're an idiot like me and dash too late. And then grab one of these dormant bombs and then throw it at her. And then use the, crossblade to ignite that bomb. And then move in when she's stunned. And then attack her. And then once she starts to recover, kind of move out of the way. Alright, and now she's going to try to mix things up a little bit. She's going to circle around, and then she's going to hit the platform, and she's going to try to dash at us. And same things with fireballs, you kind of want to just kind of dash out of the way. There we go. She's going to do this three times. Two. Come on. And then three, there we go. And then she's gonna revert back to phase one where she's trying to get us with the fireballs. Oh, you're thinking about Big Bill's hell, yeah. Bring your kids, bring your wife, we'll fuck her. That's right, we'll fuck your wife. Make sure that check doesn't bounce or you're a dead motherfucker. All right, she did the three fireballs, so now we're going to hit her with the with the bomb again and use the crossblades to ignite it. There we go. Took a little bit of damage there, but we did what we needed to do. There we go. Alright, now she's moving on to her next phase where she kind of just follows us around the arena and tries to physically attack us. Sometimes with shockwaves if we get a little too close, but other than that, she's going to use fireballs. She's going to stay on the ground for the most part from now on. But we're just going to try to avoid her attacks. Don't get too close or she will swipe you with her claws. So just keep your distance, dodge the fireballs. As long as you're staying far enough away, her shockwave isn't going to do much for you. When you see her charging up like a bull like that, I mean she's going to try to ram you. Just get ready to mash that B button so you can knock her across the arena like this. And then run up to her and try to get in a few hits. Oh, no, okay, I thought I could dash away to, oh, God. Ooh. Okay, let's go ahead and heal. I am playing poorly. I shouldn't have taken that much damage, but I wasn't paying attention. I will attribute that to my consumption of alcohol this night. I usually play better. But like I said, I'm probably just going to I'm going to do an actual like walkthrough of this game, like a properly edited walkthrough. I just figured I'd do a casual playthrough for tonight.
I might do like a live stream playthrough for the rest of this game, but you will get an actual walkthrough out of it, full of trivia and, you know, behind the scenes information, things that I've actually researched, kind of like what you usually do with that on the show. Oh no, get out of the way! There we go. Ooh, that was nice. Come on, charge at me. Yeah, we're playing the waiting game an awful lot with Tiamat. There we go. One more round of that ought to do. Dharma? Like Dharma and Greg? Oh, what was I doing? I looked off screen and then walked right into her. One more round. Oh, fortunately, she's not going to play with us. She's going to charge right at us from the get-go, so we don't have to wait that long. Come on, get stunned. There we go. This ought to do it. Hopefully, this does it. There we go. She Narcos, by the way, guys. Narcos is here. If you haven't checked out Narcos, go ahead, click on his name, sub to him. He's another streamer. Much better voice than mine.
Do it! Tear out her heart while she still lives. I want to hear her scream.
I am one of the chosen. I can grant your every wish.
Can you restore?
Kind of catch me on the hair end here, Nar. You caught me on the end of my six-pack, Gnar. Our favorite beer.
You really think he's going to let you live long enough to collect on your end?
Alright, and we get a Heart of the Chosen, one of the plot MacGuffins of the game, and like we usually do with Zelda bosses, we get a full lifestone, or this game's equivalent of the Heart Container. Like I said, this game draws a lot of comparisons with the Zelda series, and we get a full one for beating a boss.
Tragic. Without your feathered friend, how will you escape this prison of rock?
I'll find a way.
You have certainly proven yourself resourceful. Perhaps I can provide a quicker way.
Speak plainly, demon.
Serpent holes, ancient paths that worm their way beneath the husk of this dead world and beyond. I use them to get about, and for a price, so can you.
What do you want, Baldrum?
A trifle, really? The Chosen's heart. I felt its power the moment you stepped from that tower. You wound me, horseman. I would never come between you and your friend Samael. No, I only wish to look at the heart. One glance, and our bargain is sealed.
Happy Earth Rotation Day to you too, Gnar.
Samael will be pleased. The serpent holes are yours, horseman. Seek me out when you wish to use them.
He looks like he had wings at one point, but they got cut off. He's got bandages all over what looks like was left of wings. So we have serpent holes now, which are pretty much quick travel points.
You brought down Tiamat, have you? The Destroyer will not be pleased. You need Vulgrim more than ever, yes.
All right, let's see what we can buy from this guy. We've got three artifacts to trade, so we're going to end up with quite a bit of money. Got a new spell here, Immolation. I'll probably show that off later. Let's see. Go ahead and buy some skills for the scythe. Okay, there we go. And yeah, let's go ahead and use one of these serpent holes and return to Samael at the Scalding Gallow. Egyptian? I don't know about anything Egyptian in this, but this game is heavily based off of the Book of Revelations in the Holy Bible, so I'd say like a lot of Christianity in this game.
I trust that she suffered?
Not nearly enough.
Beautiful.
The interesting, considering that picture of Tim Curry you posted on Discord.
Beneath this place. But first there is an obstacle that must be removed. Ulthane, one of the Old Ones.
You didn't mention that before.
Changing the deal already, Samael.
Be silent, Bilth. My business is with the horsemen. Ulthane is no ally of the Destroyer. But you won't find the Griever without confronting the Black Hammer. And that will require strength you don't possess. Yet.
What the hell do you think you're doing, Samael?
Tell him, Watcher, how you stifle the horseman's
true
power.
Yeah, this is Darksiders.
In order to keep him on the Council's leash. War, destroy this parasite.
You so much as blink at me, and the Council will end you, both of you. I'm protected.
Not in here. You are War, rider of the Red Horse. Not some puppet on this pathetic creature's strings.
War, I will make you suffer.
Focus your anger. A great rage stirs within you, clawing to get out. You must release it, or a puppet you'll remain. You are reborn!
Are you talking about Samael or the Watcher? The Watcher is that guy right there with, you know, the one that Samael just knocked to the ground.
But there is still much power in him. For a moment I saw one.
That's Mark Hamill.
Stand alone against the Destroyer's army.
Okay, so, Our next objective is to go meet Ulthane. He stands on our way of getting to the Griever, which is the next one of the Destroyers chosen. The next heart that we need. Abhishek Gowda has subscribed. Thank you. Even though you're kind of reaching the hair end of our stream here. So, fortunately, that's really all we're going to make as far as progress for the rest of the night. I'll be picking this up at a later stream. I'll probably also be doing a full walkthrough of this game, like pre-recorded for that LP show. But in the meantime, oh boy. I don't really know if there's really much of a turnout for a raid tonight, but I don't know. Let's see who's up. We got a few people here. How many of the few people that we have here tonight are up for a little bit of a raid? Well, all right, Katie, there's a little tradition here that we have on YouTube Gaming. No, we're not raiding Spoony. Yeah, Jacob is up, and I was actually considering that. We have this thing that we call a raid. So anybody who's up for a raid, which it's not very many, didn't have much of a turnout tonight. Didn't expect much for something that's not Nintendo related. But that thing that Nightbot just posted that says hashtag that LP raid. If you're up for a raid, go ahead and copy and paste that. And if you want to, go ahead and hit up Jacob with the raid. He's playing Super Mario Maker. I will see you guys there if you want to show up there. And if you do, I will see you guys next time. And until next time, thank you for watching that LP stream. And have a one that is good.